Vanessa Gibson. She's in class. And, she has our. You don't need no notes. Amen. She would be. She would make a great preacher. I have some. There's a saying that you know I've been saying lately, and I heard it on the Joe Madison show. He says, some people make things happen. Some folk watch things happen. And then others wonder what the heck just happened. So we got to figure out which group are we in. Are we making things happen? Are we watching things happen? Or are we wondering what just happened? So let's go to work. This is what this is all about tonight. We're coming to a almost to a close. This is going beautiful. This is what I like. It. Anybody know me in the church? No, I don't keep all. I don't stay all night. I tell them to don't. You don't have to be eternal. Amen. But tonight,
yet.
Before we have our honorees, we want to present our honorees tonight. But before they come, I got two special guests that's going to do solos tonight. Amen. Kind of impromptu. Amen. And I'm going to ask that this time they're going to present their own. They're going to present their own soloist. And I'm going to start first with our treasurer of the Clergy Council of the 49th Precinct, Reverend Norman Coleman. Give him a hand clap. He's going to make his presentation. Then following that, Rabbi Dr. Keith Elijah Thompson is going to make his presentation.
Thank you, Elder Gooding. I want to introduce my wife, who is the director of music at our church, and she's also president of the Worship and Arts Auxiliary of the National Baptist Convention, right. USA Incorporated, Mrs. Angelique Banks Coleman. All right. All right.
Oh, by the way, last call for food. If anybody else wants any more food, please come now. Or forever hold your peace. You're welcome to go.
It is February, and it is African-American History Month, and the music that is truly American, that is only American, truly American, that got its start as American music. Any other music came from Europe, but the spiritual is truly American music. And so I'd like to sing for you a spiritual, since we are in African American month. I want to be ready. 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 Lord, ready to put on the long white robe. Oh, to put on my long white robe.
by the grace of the Lord, all of us are going to put on a long, wide robe. Those of us that are serving God in spirit and in truth. A special greeting to every one of you that are here in the most excellent and glorious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. While I was sitting there, there's a lot of talk came to me, and I realized that we have 10 fingers. There are some who have a little bit more, but the normal finger is 10 fingers. And when I look at these 10 fingers, the tallest one signifies that you must put God first in your life. The second tallest means you must eat the best. Whatever you can afford to eat, it must be the best. Because food is the stuff of life. If you don't eat, you will not live long. The third one, I believe I fall in the category, always wear the best. Dress nice. And look good. Somebody say amen to that. Because when you dress nice, you can fit in here. Number four, if you notice this big one, it's and this big one here, number four, love everybody and treat everybody right. See that? When you love everyone, then they will turn around and love you again. Number five, the smallest finger, think right. For as you think, so you will be. Come on, give the Lord a praise for that. Now, next time, I will tell you the next five. But the most powerful force in the universe is love. And if we can able to love each other, then that will make a great difference in our life. And as our councilwoman have indicated, faith without work is dead. You must always do something. Do something to help the community. I am in this community from 1980, and our church is right here in Barnes Avenue, 2910 Barnes Avenue, Bronx Miracle Gospel Tabernacle Word of Faith Ministry. And I'm serving in this community for 36 years, you know, as a pastor. Can you imagine 36 years and have to deal with people and looking so good? And that's a blessing, you know?
It's a blessing.
And the reason for it, I love people and I walk by faith and not by sight. Amen? My daughter's here, my wife is here, and some of the graduates from Bronx Miracle. Would you all stand and everybody see you all how beautiful you all are? Okay, and at this time my daughter gonna come, and my daughter Cherise Celeste Thompson. Put your hands together for her, and she's gonna sing a song.
Called Never Give Up, so Give Up Now by Mary Mary.
There will be mountains that I would have to climb, and there will be battles that I would have to fight, but victory or defeat is up to me to decide. But how can I expect to win if I never try? I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I started.
Me this far to leave me.
Oh, yes.
never said there would be trials. Never said I wouldn't fall. Never said that everything would go the way I wanted to go. But when my back is against the wall,
oh, yes,
and it feels like hope is gone, I just lift my hands up to the sky and say, help me to be strong. Oh, I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. Come on, sing it with me.
Oh, yes.
I just can't give up. I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. And I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. And I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me.
Preachers have some talent. I'm gonna leave that alone. I had a joke there, but I'm gonna leave that one out. I'll say that when I see y'all privately. We're certainly grateful again tonight for these honorees that have been selected, and I just want to make one notice. I had nothing to do with this, but I want to thank our committee that selected the honorees on tonight. And again, certainly again, we want to thank you. Before I do that, though, I just want to acknowledge, especially the pastors that's in our clergy tonight. I'm going to ask Bishop Courtney and Reed. Amen. Stand up, Bishop Reed. Good to have you here. Give him a hand clap. Reverend Dr. Milton Gregory is here. Amen. Victory Seventh-day Adventist Church.
All right.
Bishop Reed is the pastor of the City of Faith. What other pastors are here? Any other pastors here? That's part of our clergy council. Dr. Gawler, yeah, Reverend Dr. Charles Gawler. Yeah, I want to acknowledge him. We can always depend on Reverend Dr. Gawler, I tell you. And we're certainly grateful to have with us all of the pastors that make up this setting tonight. I'm going to ask Reverend Pastor Riddle is going to come back. We're going to start first tonight with honoring our executive board. He have chosen the executive board. Him and the committee have chosen the executive board tonight. So I'm going to ask them to come at this time. And I'm going to ask our honorees to come from our executive board if they would just come up right quick.
Give Reverend David Hurst with that.
dedication, for your time and dedication in breaking barriers and building the gap in our community. The Clergy Council of the 49 Precinct, February 2nd, 2017. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, Rabbi.
Now, next is our first vice president, Dr. Hamoud. Come on. He's a doctor. He wears all the hats. Our second vice president, Rabbi Dr. Keith Elijah Thompson.
Bless you.
Our third vice president is Reverend Riddle. Let's give him a hand clap. Yeah. It's because of his hard work tonight that we are here, and I want to personally thank him for his perseverance and commitment tonight. Amen. Even though he didn't win an award, we'd be remiss if we did not give him
an award tonight. Let's give him another hand for putting this together tonight.
Jewish faith, we got Sheikh Amud of our Muslim faith, and the rest of the brothers here of our Christian faith. So we thank God for God for giving us a diverse group.
All right.
Next, the one who keeps the books, and he has a singing wife. We're grateful. Our treasurer, Reverend Norman Coleman, pastor of the Burke Avenue. Secretary, and she does a tremendous job behind the scenes. And she sends out the notifications to everybody. Evangelist Donna Sled.
We would definitely be remiss tonight, and I tell you, he's one of the ones that. If it wasn't for him, we would probably not be here tonight, because from day one, he had been with me. And, our community council president, words can't express, express what he has done for us and how he has stood with us. We would not, and I'm saying this very seriously, this is what they say in the streets, real talk. I'm keeping it 100. We would not be here tonight if it wasn't for this man. Amen. Mr. Joe Thompson. Come on, let's receive him. I'm not going to have him give another speech, though.
You used up your time, Joe.
We don't have any time tonight. You can speak to Reverend Dr. Hargrave after this. Doctor, I gotta go to bed tonight. Our committee members that have worked with our brother Riddle, Pastor Riddle, Grace.
Oh.
Where's Grace at? I'm gonna mess up Lavaglio. Yeah. Did I say it right?
Yep.
Yeah, that's my Italian. Yeah. Sit down. And our Jan Muhammad, he's one of our newest members, but he's come put his hands to the plow. So let's give our clergy council, let's give them a hand clap. Come on, give them another. I think we ought to give them a standing. These folk make things happen. Proud of you. God bless y'all. Now, we certainly And I want to thank the committee because they really did this, and I didn't even know who they had down to do this. And Reverend Riddle would explain about the their medals tonight.
I'm going to start off like this. We got a bunch of beautiful sisters in this room. Amen? But we got three special sisters that I consider special from the DA's department. Now, when y'all hear DA, I know y'all got to get a little nervous because the other day one said, we prosecute. That's what we do. We prosecute. That's what we do. But they do other things. Like help the community, do workshops.
Right.
They teach. They come and visit and talk. They say hello, goodbye, I'm hungry. That's right. And our three sisters, may you please stand. Now, we got like a two-part award for them. And the second part is on the way. So, but we got one part here now. You know how they do in court, right? You come back and get your sentence. But we're going to convict you now. But you come back and we're going to sentence. So we're going to ask you to come up right now, please.
Come on, come on.
And I want to thank God for the Crime Victims Unit, our coordinator, director, Ms. Bethann Rosen is here tonight also representing. Let me talk about, and this is just a little something, as Reverend Riddle said tonight, we're going to even make up something even greater for these ladies. This young lady here that I'm standing next to have been such a tremendous, I've been knowing this lady, I guess, for about at least 10 years or so, and she has participated in everything that we have done, and I'm certainly grateful. I think now since the new DA is on the scene, I haven't seen her around. You still with the DA's office? Or you retired? Okay. 6 months, you gonna retire? Lord Jesus. Where you going, girl? Get out, though. Are you serious? Go to the ATF. Oh, my God. I love this lady here. She has been tremendous in all that we have done in our clergy, not just for the 4-9, but for all over the city. And for many of years, she has done a tremendous job. We're just honored to have her to be a part of what we have done here in the Clergy Council of 49. Can we just give a standing ovation, Miss Jeanette Creamer Johnson? Let me personally dress you tonight.
Executive Board, the officers of NYPD, to the members of the Clergy Council of the 49th Precinct, and to the guests. Thank you for honoring me this evening. It has been a pleasure and a great opportunity to be part of this coalition since 2012. I have witnessed the work you have done in the community, standing up to violence, the National Night Out Against Crime, the gun buyback program, and that's just to name a few. May God continue to bless you, to give you the vision to do his work in the community, and also for making the Bronx safe. God bless you, and I love you.
All right. All right. All right.
So when I come to Georgia, I'll be checking you out. Next but not least, the young lady who has taken her place for the last few months, and she comes to every meeting. As a matter of fact, she has so many ideas, and I see her all around now at all the meetings, the 4-9, 4-7, you name it, she's there. Miss Rayshawn Horry, let's give her a hand clap.
Training me on everything that I know, and I just wanted to say thank you, of course, to the 49 Council. You make me feel at home, and I'm looking forward to work even more. Thank you.
All right.
And I want to thank Beth Ann Halsey for allowing Priscilla. She right there. Come on, you might as well come stand with her. Come stand. Come stand with her woman. Come on. Amen. Priscilla Tavares. She has been tremendous in, you know, what they do with Beth Ann, standing by Beth Ann's side for the crime victims. They did an awesome presentation, actually, to our clergy council. And I think it's something all pastors need to know and bring back to their parishioners and their churches and to their mosque and their synagogues. But this young lady has been tremendous. She's faithful. She got the most beautiful smile. She looked like a little doll baby. Miss Priscilla Tavares, let's give her a hand clap.
Wow, thank you, thank you. I feel really honored. Thank you so much, Pastor Gooding. I want to thank the Clergy Coalition for the 49th Precinct as well. Thank you. I also want to thank my director, Miss Beth Ann Halsey. Thank you for believing in me. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to be a part of the Crime Victims Unit. I've learned so much from you. So thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. I also want to thank DA Hart for allowing me to continue at the northern part of the Bronx as a coordinator for the Bronx DA's Crime Victims Unit. Mm. And to all my colleagues too, Ray Sean, Mr. Lecrimer Johnson, thank you so much because I've learned so much and it's a great team working at the DA's office. And I look forward to continue. I look forward to servicing the northern part of the Bronx. And thank you once again. Thank you. I'm telling you.
Come on, let's give our Bronx DA's office a hand clap tonight for doing that. Beth, you want to say something, Beth? Come on, you put me on the spot at Columbia.
Good evening. Thank you, Pastor Gooding, for allowing me to be your guest. I truly love him. He always shows up for anything that we do, for the clients that we serve. We did a conference not too long ago for homicide survivors. And Pastor Gooden and SUV always come out for us and support the clients that we have. Priscilla, I just love her. And I say this from the bottom of my heart. Hopefully I'm not going to get. She is one of the kindest, one of the kindest people that I know. She loves her work, and she does it from the bottom of her heart. So,
all right.
Thank you. Thank you.
I got this award in my hand for a special brother. A brother that went to school with my wife years ago. My wife, when we met years ago, she used to talk about him, and I used to wonder, who is he? And that was that. Until I got to meet him and walk and talk with him. I found out, you know, she was telling the truth, but I'm glad she chose me. Glad she chose me. That's right. Where's that beautiful woman at? But listen, Pastor Gooding. I want to present to you. Come on now. Thank you.